Sunday Gambit.
Thank you. For sound, do you have any tips for avoiding the sound, like rubbing against the shirt or wind?
Sure. Yeah. So if you're recording outside, it's inevitable you're going to get wind at some point. You got to do something about it. Or if you're have your thing clipped to your shirt, something at some point is going to ruffle against it. So to answer your first question about ruffling your ruffling shirt against the microphone, a lot of times that comes down to the type of shirt you have. So I spent a summer working as a sound recordist on a feature film, and when I was doing that, basically my job was for every scene that we shot, I would have to hide a microphone, just like this one, on each actor in a place that the camera couldn't see. Problem with that is, if you're hiding it under somebody's shirt, you're gonna get a lot of noise of this shirt rubbing against the microphone. So what I would have to do is just get very creative about finding places to hide the microphone that weren't gonna create as much noise. So there are different places, I guess, depending on what type of shirt you're wearing. But as you can see in my video, because I'm doing this on YouTube, I didn't really work too hard to hide my microphone. Because for YouTube videos, I feel like people don't really look for the microphone. If it was in a movie and somebody saw a microphone on your shirt, and you were watching a big movie star and all of a sudden you saw his microphone, you'd be like, hey, he's wearing a microphone. If you're watching your favorite YouTuber and you see that there's a microphone clipped to their shirt, you're like, oh, okay, they're wearing a microphone. It's very different. Sometimes even when I'm watching the news on live television, I'll see the microphone and I just won't care. But now, if it was my favorite movie star and it's this big movie, it just wouldn't fly. So I think there's some grace where I'm not as concerned about hiding the microphone in a YouTube video as much as I am making sure it's in a place where it's not going to be touched by my shirt. So as long as I know that my microphone is in a place where no fabric is going to rub against it, then I'm okay. Just got to use my eyes, got to think about it for a second, and you'll find a good place. Usually, if you're wearing a button-down shirt or a sweater or something like that, that's a good place. Of course, your collar is good a lot of times. Ideally, you want the microphone to be pointed toward your mouth, but since this is an omnidirectional microphone, if you don't get that pointed right at your mouth, you'll still get some decent sound. In this video, the microphone is here and it's pointed this direction. And you heard that it's still got okay sound. So as far as for wind, now wind is a big issue. There are actually people who spend thousands of dollars on products to avoid recording the sound of wind, because the wind in your microphone is going to sound terrible. It's going to sound like, and it's going to be louder than your voice. Now, with a lav mic, you don't get as much wind. So there was a time, actually this happened just a couple months ago. I was shooting a video, and the subject was standing in front of a lake. And my camera was 10 feet away from him, and he was just saying his lines in front of the lake. And because I used this microphone, and I didn't really hide it, but I did kind of put it under his shirt. So he had a coat, he had a jacket, and then he had just his t-shirt. I kind of hung it under the t-shirt so that sound could still go through the fabric, but the wind wouldn't. And I gotta tell you, actually, do I still have that? Oh, Okay, so actually this is a perfect, because I can show you this example. So this is the sound from the camera.
This is gonna be
you're all that
Tevin's video take one. It's kind of hard because it's really take two.
But I had this microphone on him, hidden kind of under his coat so the wind couldn't get to it. So you want to hear how that turned out?
I'm Kevin Fetris. All my adult life, I've dreamed of making movies for a living. For someone like me who loves to tell stories.
Now, this microphone by itself, just because you bought it and you pushed a button, it's not automatically going to make all your sound go, all your noise go away. Just got to think about it a little bit. You just got to think, where is the wind not going to blow on this microphone? Where is the clothes not going to rub against the microphone? You know, and it's going to be different in most situations because our clothes are different, because we go outside and the weather is different every day. So you just gotta kinda ask yourself those two questions before you put it on. So, great question, thanks for bringing that up.
Are you on YouTube?
Currently I don't have a YouTube channel. Most of what I do right now is for my clients.
What do you do?
So I do a couple of different things. So I have a company that does wedding videos, as well as a company that does marketing videos, and I also do a lot of work for a nonprofit organization in Tinley Park. I also have worked in feature films and entertainment films. So I have a short film that's out on Amazon called The Scavenger. David was telling you guys about that earlier. Talks about that in the flyer. I've worked on a couple of Hollywood films like Batman versus Superman. I also
Ooh.
Worked.
Yay!
Yeah. Not my favorite movie, but it was one of my favorite sets to be on. So I've worked on a few different movies, and now that I'm getting things squared away with my company, I'm gonna start working more on creating that kind of content, movies and web series and things like that.
Okay. So you're going to be on YouTube.
Maybe not YouTube, but there I'm definitely going to be online somewhere.
Okay.
So, way back in the day, I used to have a YouTube channel where I would be in front of the camera all the time. Back when I was first starting out, 8-9 years ago. So, if you ever want to see a really young, really hyper Jeremy. It might be still out there. I won't tell you where.
Search, right?
Exactly.
Okay.
Right. Cool. So with that being said, how are we doing on time, Michelle?
We can have 5 to 10.
5 to 10 minutes. Okay. So I was gonna spend a little time talking about how to navigate the waters of YouTube, and how to channel more traffic to your channel. I don't have a whole lot of time to talk about it, and personally my expertise is much more in the production side of things than the marketing side of things, but I can give you guys a few points of advice. So, but the very first thing, and this goes before you record your video, before you even start your YouTube channel, you should know who your target audience is. So, the lady over here, and I'm sorry, I missed your name.
Sha.
Sha knows who her target audience is. People who want to learn about yoga. And she knows what kind of people usually want to learn about yoga, Sha.
Any health, want to promote health,
sure.
Fitness, healthy lifestyle.
People who want to be healthy mostly.
Yeah.
People who are conscious of their bodies.
Mm-hmm.
And do you find that there's more women or men?
More women.
Much more women, right?
Surprisingly.
And is there like a certain age range? Do you find more children? Do you find more teenagers? More adults?
Yoga definitely more for more adults. Mm-hmm. Even though children can benefit from it, mm-hmm. but they're more hyper. They want to learn hip hop, breakdance,
right.
rather than yoga.
Gotcha. So she knows who her audience is. Her audience is adult women who are conscious about their health. It's pretty specific, right? Knowing who your audience is before you make your move with your video is the most important thing you can do. You gotta decide on the audience first. She's got adult women who are conscious about their health. Somebody else, it might be sports enthusiasts or movie fans, or it might be this or that. But you gotta specifically nail down who those people are and then think, well, what does a person in that group want to see in a YouTube video? What's going to make them interested? What are the issues facing these people that they care about right now? And what can I do to help them with my YouTube video? And if you start there, you're going to get a lot more views than if you start with, well, I really like yoga, and I'm going to make a yoga video. Because now you're thinking about the people you're making it for, rather than just thinking about yourself. Does that make sense? So as long as you're thinking about your audience first, you're going to get more views. Second thing is, and this is, you know, seems like a very small detail, but think about what you're naming your video. So the title that you use in your video is really important, because people are going to search, you know how YouTube is. You kind of scroll through like 100 videos every 10 minutes, and you probably only click on one, right? So you want to have your title be something that not only tells me what the video is about, but makes me ask a question that I need to have answered. You know, so I used to have a client who did this, and I tell him all the time not to do this, and he didn't stop, and it drove me crazy. He named his show, his name was Ryan Carr, so he named his show, each episode of the of his show was The Ryan Carr Show, Episode 5, December 12th, 2017. And I was like, no one's gonna click on that.
Yeah.
He would talk about Hollywood news in his show. And I would say, you know, if today we're talking about Tom Cruise, and you're talking about the deal that he's signing with this studio, you should name the video, is Mission Impossible 6 coming out? Because that's a question, right? Mm-hmm. And people want to know the answer to that question. And even if the answer is no, it's not Mission Impossible 5, it's another movie that he's doing. Mission Impossible 5 already came out. Never mind. But you get the idea. Something that's going to make people who care about the topic want to know more. So having a little bit of creativity and putting a little thought into the names of your videos so that the people in your audience will be compelled to watch them, it's going to go a long way. So there's two tips for you. Know who your target audience is.